Hey, how you doing, my friends? This is Mainly Butch coming at you from the southern coast of Maine, that state way up at the top on the East Coast. Today is Father's Day, June 18th, and I am just hanging out, and I thought that I would do a short video, which probably is going to turn into kind of a long video actually here, about this week in America. Because, man, let me tell you something right now. I don't know how many of you watch me from out of this country, but the United States is in total political fucking meltdown chaos right now. It is un-friggin' believable the shit that is going down. As you all know, we have the biggest idiot in the world posing as president of this country. And not a day goes by that he doesn't throw some sort of a friggin' temper tantrum on Twitter about something that is either totally untrue, completely fabricated from his wild imagination, or is like a stretch on the truth, you know? And it goes on daily, and the daily shit that goes on around the world that should be concerning this man has no effect on him whatsoever. He does not care about anything that's happening anywhere else in this country or the world, except what's happening in the first 3 feet around his body. You know, he doesn't care about shootings and killings around the country. He doesn't care that the police are murdering black men left and right. He doesn't care that the cops are getting away with it like they did this week. He doesn't care about the earthquakes in Guatemala, the fires in London, you know, the fires in Peru. He doesn't care about terrorist attacks in any other country. He doesn't care about any of that shit. All he cares about is Donald J. Trump and the 3 feet that surround him. And he wants to be praised like a motherfucker. So, you know, the scene is really, really bad. I got some notes here because it was a long week and a lot of shit happened this week. You know, a lot of really interesting shit. You know why? Because he's getting scared. The man should be scared. He's under investigation for all kinds of shit. So, and he's supposed to be the leader of this country, which he has not yet shown us or done anything that's leaderish at all. You know, everything he touches turns to total shit. And he's really trying to take us down the crapper. And I, amongst many other millions of Americans, I'm really, really sick of it. And it is not the way that we think. It's not the way that we have been taught. It's not the way of the world that we live in. You know, we want to be part of NATO. We want to be there for other countries when they need us, and we want them for us when we need them. You know, our president thinks a whole different way. You know, he's like, fuck NATO, you know, and he's crazy. this week alone, you know, the cop killer got away with murder and was let off. I can't remember the guy's name now. There's just no justice for these victims. These cops are just getting let off on technicalities, and all they gotta say is, "I felt threatened," and they get off. They can shoot and kill these men for no good reason. You know, this guy was sitting in the car with his girlfriend and a kid in the back seat, and the cop shoots him and kills him, and then gets away with it, gets acquitted. That's bullshit. You know, I don't care what color anybody was in the situation. It is bullshit. It was murder. It's particularly happening to young black men, and I understand this. You know, and I'm sorry for that. I really am. It's not fair. It's not fair at all. It's not fair that it should be a way of life for them at all. But then we had, these are some of the famous things that happened this week. Then we had a congressman shot. Okay, so the congressman is Scalia is playing baseball, and some guy that got upset with him went out and shot him and put him in the hospital. Okay, you would have thought that was the only shooting in America on that day, you know, but there were many other shootings in America on that same day. There were many other shootings that involved killing in America on that same day. Yet the news media and the politicians that spoke on television all focused on just that one shooting. You know, I guess you got to be Republican to make the news. You got to be Republican to get justice. You know, it's fucked up. And he was saved by a lesbian cop. and a DC cop who is an out lesbian, and she was wounded also. And I hope she recovers. And I'm anxious to hear her speak about what happened in the situation, especially when she saved one of the most racist men in America, a man that likened himself to David Duke. Yeah, this happens. This is happening in America. This is fucking horrendous. You know? And what's Trump doing all week? He's whining still about the investigations, calling them witch hunts. You know? The guy is crazy. You know, his papers have been now subpoenaed by Robert Mueller. They want to see his financial papers. Maybe one day we'll see his tax returns. They want to see documentation. So his stuff has been subpoenaed. Well, he's ignoring the whole world, all these things that are happening in the world. He's whining about being investigated. He's whining about he's the greatest thing since sliced fucking bread. No, he's not. He's delusional. He's insane. Some people say he's got syphilis and it's infected his brain. That's one of the rumors going around out there. That's probably fake news. Okay. All the stuff I'm talking to you about has come from major news sources. So, this is not fake news, guys. This stuff really is happening here in America. We had six experts in HIV and AIDS resign from the President's HIV and AIDS Advisory Council. Trump refuses to meet with them. He refuses to acknowledge that the council exists. He removed their webpage from the White House webpages on day one of his fucking presidency. You know, he's not dealing with any of these crises, health crises, any type of crisis, he's not dealing with it. He's not dealing with the storms and tornadoes in the Midwest. He's not dealing with anything except his little, I'm being investigated, oh my God. People hate me. Nobody can hate me. He actually had a cabinet meeting where he had his 13 cabinet members. 13 he's got in place out of thousands. You know, he had this cabinet meeting and he talked about how great it was and how this was the greatest presidency ever in time. Nobody could compare to him. And then he went around and he asked every single person at the table to praise him. The man needs to be coddled. He's like a toddler. It's unfucking real. 13 Republicans and they did it. They did it. They actually sat and kissed his fucking ass. You know, it's ridiculous. I don't know what is wrong with these Republicans. So, the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals has ruled once again against the travel ban, the illegal travel ban, the unconstitutional travel ban of Donald Trump. That makes him so happy. He hates our judicial system, which, you know, no president in the world should be at odds with our judicial system, yet he is. He's fired Comey, he's got Mueller, he's talking about firing Mueller now, he doesn't like, you know, Sessions, he doesn't like anybody, you know, the new assistant attorney general that's taken over there, his name, it slips my mind, begins with an R, but, you know, he's talking about replacing him, talking about making him recuse himself, all this other shit. There's speculation that he's going to fire Mueller, like he fired Comey for investigating him. You know, this is speculation again. There's a federal lawsuit that was taken out by 200 Democratic congressmen to, you know, the lawsuit is because he's been profiting from businesses dealing with him, you know, from foreign governments. You know, he's getting them to stay at his hotels when they come to visit him and play at his golf courses, and he's profiting big time from this presidency, believe me. You know, the Senate voted unanimously to let Congress strip the president of the unilateral ability to lift sanctions on Russia. At least they did one thing right. You know, at least they did one thing right. So Trump can't just go and say there's no more sanctions on Russia like he wants to do because Putin wants him to do that. No, he has to. Congress has taken that ability away from him. And at least they took something away from this motherfucker. So, you know, now Mueller is now looking into whether Trump is obstructing justice, or has obstructed justice, is continuing to obstruct justice. Man is a lunatic. We have a lunatic running this fucking country. You know? And he has confirmed publicly that he's under investigation. So there is no doubt that the man is under investigation. Even though tonight, Sunday night, his lawyer comes out and says, Trump's not under investigation. That was a mistweet. Yeah, bullshit. Trump says he doesn't make mistakes. That wasn't a mistreat. He's under investigation. Bigly, as he say. Yeah, so that's what's happening here in America. It's fucking crazy. And people are at each other's throats, okay? Even one of my siblings came at me this week and said, what is it, all liberals can just kill Republicans now? Because he's a Republican and I happen to be a liberal. Or I border on that liberal thing, you know? I'm not liberal in all my opinions, but I'm liberal in a lot of them. You know, I don't want my climate to go to hell. I want to be part of the Paris Accord. I don't want my country to go to hell. I want to be part of NATO. You know, I don't want to kick all people that aren't white out of this country like Trump does. I know there's actually a senator down south that's running a new campaign. His slogan is Make America White Again. Do you believe that? In 2017, the man has got a slogan like that. It's hard to be American right now. It's hard to be American and be proud, honestly. You know, as an American veteran, I find it so hard to be proud of this country right now. We need to have a leader that knows how to talk, that can read, that understands American history, that understands politics and how you deal with people, that has a mind, that uses his people that work for him to keep him up to date on what's going on in his country and around the world, so that he's addressing things properly. We need to get rid of Trump. He needs to resign. Right now, he's hiding in Camp David. He called Camp David a hillbilly heaven one time. He says it is a rustic junk place. He didn't like it. This is his first trip to Camp David. So he's hiding in Camp David. He refuses to talk to anyone in his staff. He refuses to talk to anyone. He's hiding. Why? I think he's getting ready to resign. I think the man has finally come to the conclusion that people fucking hate him. And he needs to go away. He's not a politician. Donald Trump, you are not a politician. You are a businessman. You are a real estate broker. You're good at that. Well, I don't know, $316 billion in debt. I don't know how good at it you are, but that's what you do. You're not a good president at all. I hope you guys all are doing well. I know this is a long video, but it had to be said. Peace.